So how did I get there?
I don't know.
You know what I think? I think the guy sitting right next to you, that blonde guy. Daniel, right? I think he had something to do with this.
Okay, listen to me. I've known Daniel since my baseball days. He's the quiet kind of guy. He would never do something like that.
Oh, Nick, come on, man. You can't even remember last night. I look away for, what, 5 seconds, and you got yourself a symbol on your arm. And what happens 10 seconds later? Daniel's gone. You don't think that's suspicious? And even a little bit?
You know what? Maybe you did this.
Yeah, maybe I did it. You know what? If you're gonna start acting like an 8-year-old, I don't have time for this.
Damn it. Hey, Nick.
Hey, Nick. Nick? Nick? Another note. I'm worried. I don't know where to look, but I think it's time to have a little word with the cops. So I went to the police, and after a long wait at the desk, the answer was...
The chief is kind of busy now, so...
I was so pissed off, I could strangle the girl, but that did not really seem like a good idea at the time. Out of a sudden, the chief walked past me. The bitch lied to me, but it really didn't matter right now. I asked him about Daniel. His surname turned out to be Dawson. He also showed me a photograph of him. It was definitely the Daniel that I saw at the party, but I would never get to meet him. He committed suicide on the night after the party. The cop just ran away. I wanted to ask him one last question, but he didn't have the time. But it didn't matter now. The prime suspect is already dead. 2 months have gone by, and Nick is dead, found rotting in the woods. Suddenly, I got a call from a Gary Dawson, who would agree to have a word with me at the church in 2 days. Nobody's around.
only thing I found was a note. I deciphered it. It says,
"Dear Chris, please don't blame Daniel. He has not killed Nick. That was me."
He turned out to be Daniel's father, the coach of the baseball team.